Hello students, I am Swati Kedar. In today's C# session, we are going to see one more C# practice program, that is on the jump statement. You know the jump statement, Varsha ma'am already told you in the C# theory class. The jump statement are used to transfer the control from one point to another point in the program due to some specified code while executing the program. It transfers the control from one point to another point in the program, and there are the few keywords in the jump statement: the break, continue, go to, return, throw. And in today's session we're going to see the break and continue statement. And the first is the break statement is used to terminate the loop or a statement in which it present, means it come out of the loop in which it present. After that, the control pass to the next break statement if the available. And the continue statement are used to skip over the execution part of the loop on a certain condition, means it skip the execution part of that loop. And after that it transfers the control to beginning of the loop. And this jump statement program, we going to see the execution in two ways in Visual Studio 2017. And second way, we type the program in Notepad and execute on developer command prompt. So let's start with the in first way. For that, you have to open the Visual Studio and go to File, New, Project, Visual C#, ConsoleApp.net Framework. Give here your project name. I give here jump. Statements, and give here a location for your project. For that, you have to browse, go to this PC, go to the drive and create here new folder, or I have created here new folder C# program. So I choose that folder and click on select folder and click on OK. After the clicking on OK, the C# file will be open, and you see here this coding comes by default. You don't change it, keep as it is. And I have already typed here one program for the jump statement. So go through the coding and you see here using system, this is the namespace. I have already told you using system, this is the namespace, and it contains data types, classes, methods. Using system.collection or generic, it contains garbage collection data. Using system.link, it links one file to another file. And using system.text, it contains this text. After that, namespace jump statement, we created here namespace jump statement. Under the namespace, we create here a class and methods. The class program, you can change here class name also. I give one here class program. Under the class, I created here the main method, static void main string aux. This is the main method, and program execution starts from this method only. In the main method, we created here one variable I of a type integer, int I semicolon. And we taken here for loop for I is equal to 1, I is less than equal to 10, I plus plus. Under the for loop, if condition, if I is equal to 5, then continue statement. After that, if condition, if I is equal to 8, the break statement. After that, console dot write line in bracket in double quote value is, and value of I is here printed, semicolon. And close here flower bracket of the for loop. After that, console.readline method semicolon. You have to close the all brackets and save the program. And for execution, you have to click on start. This is the execution of this program. You see here value is 1, value is 2, value is 3, value is 4, value is 6, value is 7. You see here 5 is not printed here because of the continue statement, and 8 also not printed because of the break statement. And this is the execution in Visual Studio. And now we are going to see this program execution in second way, that is on, we type the program in notepad and execute on developer command prompt. For that you have to copy that program and paste it here, and for saving you have to go for file, the file, click on save, go to the drive, go to the drive and choose your folder, create your folder and give here file name. I give the file name jump statements.cs. You don't forward the this extension.cs for the C# file and click on save. The file is now saved and we go for execution. For that you have to open the developer command prompt. You see here we by default we are in C drive. For that and our file is in D drive, so for that we have to go in the D drive. For that you have to type here D colon. Now we are in D drive and give here your folder path. For that you have to type here CD C# program, that is the folder name, C# program. Now we are in D drive in our folder, and now we go for the compilation of the file. For that you have to type here CSC jump dash file name statements.cs with extension. You have to compile the file. The now file will be compiled, and now we go for execution. For execution you have to give here only file name, without the extension you have to give here file name jump statements and enter. You see here the output of this program. This is the execution in a developer command prompt. Now we go for the tracing of this program, and this is the main coding of this program. Int I, for I is equal to 1, I is less than equal to 10, I plus plus. Under the for loop, if I is equal to 5, then continue statement. If I is equal to 8, then break statement. Then console dot write line in bracket in double quote value is double quote complete, and I value will be printed semicolon and bracket complete. This is the main program. Now we see the tracing of this program. First, I value is 1 in for loop for I is equal to 1, and 1 is less than equal to 10. S then it enters into the for loop, then it checks for the condition. If I is equal to 5, I value is 1 is equal to 5, no condition is false, so it goes to next condition. If I is equal to 8, I value is here 1 is equal to 8, no condition is false, so it simply prints the value is 1. After that value I will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 2 here in for loop for I is equal to 2, 2 is less than equal to 10, as then it checks for the condition. If 2 is equal to 5, I value is here 2, so 2 is equal to 5, no false, condition is false, then it goes to the next condition. If I value is equal to 8 and I value is here 2 is equal to 8, no condition is false, so it simply prints the value is here 2. Now I value will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 3 in for loop for I is equal to 3, 3 is less than equal to 10, as then it checks for the condition. If condition, if 3 is equal to 5, no condition is false, then it come to the next condition. If 3 is equal to 8, no condition is false, then it prints the value is 3. After that the I value will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 4. Now 4 for I is equal to 4, 4 is less than equal to 10, S, then it checks for the condition. If 4 is equal to 5, no, condition is false. Then it comes to the next condition. If 4 is equal to 8, no, condition is false. Then it prints the value of I here. Value is, I value is 4. Then I value will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 5 in for loop 4. I is equal to 5, 5 is less than equal to 10. Then it checks for the condition. If 5 is equal to 5, as the condition is true, then it executes the continue statement. You see here continue. The after the continue, it goes to the beginning of the loop, means it will not print the 5. It goes to the beginning of this for loop, and I value will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 6 for I is equal to 6, 6 is less than equal to 10, S. Then it checks for the condition. If 6 is equal to 5, the condition is false. Then it comes to next condition. If 6 is equal to 8, the condition is false. Then it prints the value of I. The value is, I value is here 6. So it prints the 6. Then I value will be incremented now by 1. Now I value is 7 for I is equal to 7, 7 is less than equal to 10, S. Then if 7 is equal to 5, the condition is false. Then it comes to next condition. If 7 is equal to 8, the condition is false. Then it prints the I value here. Value is, I value is here 7. Now I value will be incremented by 1. Now I value is 8. In for loop for I is equal to 8, I is less than equal to 10, it checks for the condition. If 8 is equal to 5, no, condition is false. Then next, if condition, if 8 is equal to 8, the condition is true. Next, break, it means it come out of the loop without printing of 8. It come out of the loop, and output you see here, value is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be skipped by here. 5 will not print here. Then it prints value 6, value 7, and 8 also will not print because of the break statement. And 5 also will not print because of the continue statement. The continue statement, it goes to the beginning of the loop, and break statement, it come out of the loop. So this is the execution of this program jump statement.